Hi everybody, I hope you're well. Today we'll read from a book titled NASA Apollo 11, Man on the Moon, The Visual Archive by Stephen Knoll, published by Spector Books.
Space, the Final Frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before. These iconic words from the title sequence of Star Trek were first broadcast in the United States on NBC on September 8, 1966. This television series about the journey of Captain Kirk and his crew on their adventures exploring the vast reaches of space fueled enthusiasm for space travel within the US society. This fascination, however, was in no way founded solely upon the success and popularity of the Star Trek series. It had begun more than a decade earlier. Stephen Knoll wrote, "I am a communication designer, not a historian, astronaut, or astronomer. To me, this project is not primarily about individual historical facts and turns of events, about technological innovations or different types of engineering, art, or similar performances, even though I have great respect for the fact that without these accomplishments and achievements in various fields, this book wouldn't exist. Instead, this project is about a designer's perspective on history and the telling of that story, a story that is told through and especially with the aid of images, and is supported by conceptual ideas of the layout, the symbiosis of form and content, by use of printing technology and truthful depiction, all in the form of sequences of images. My wish is to complete the ambitious Full Moon project by Michael Light, at least as far as the Apollo 11 mission is concerned, and in so doing grant access to photo archives that may exist on the internet and are well known among experts, but not to the general public. This book attempts to maintain a balance between the impression of scientific and meticulously written documents on the one hand and a tribute to history in the form of images on the other. In doing so, minor alterations to the photographs and the associated condensing of essential aspects are used as tools, such as adapting the images of the Apollo 11 moon landing to a modified color context. Similarly, the interplay between a rather conservative sans-serif font in reference to NASA's remastered corporate design from 1975 and a pop culture condensed font evocative of newspaper and headline titles serves two purposes, renegotiating the form and content as well as the array of images. If the publication was ever committed to a goal apart from recounting the moon landing odyssey and using the photographic documentation as contemporary witness, that goal would be to inspire readers about the topic. The fact that this book also demonstrates that publications, at least those with a scientific background, can certainly be appealingly designed is only a byproduct of these efforts. The Apollo 11 mission was a pop culture media event of the superlative. 500 million people watched Neil Armstrong live as he turned manned flight to the moon into a reality, producing over 100,000 images, countless cover photos and picture stories. This mission was predominantly shaped by its visual documentation and reception. For the July 25, 1969 issue of Life magazine, Neil Armstrong appeared in full space gear on the cover with the title Living for the Moon. The August 8 issue, called On the Moon, also showed a photograph from the mission, namely of the US flag raised on the moon's surface. Finally, the publication of the special issue, To the Moon and Back, completed the circle regarding the trip to the moon. Although the technique has been in use for about 100 years, the photographic process, along with associated evidence and the documentation of information and events with the aid of photography, has led to its becoming a dominating medium of this era. Over the course of 3 years and 6 manned missions to the moon, images of daily work and training situations were taken to capture the spectacular first achievements in the history of astronautics. As early as the 1960s, and with an almost prophetic look ahead, Richard Underwood, NASA's chief of photography, had informed astronauts of the fact that the key to immortality lies in mastering the aperture, shutter speed, and focus. "Your key to immortality is in the quality of the photographs, and nothing else. It is impossible to look at the countless images of the moon taken during the Apollo missions and not see the history of photography itself within them."
The book was designed by Studio Tillack-Knoll and printed in Germany by Office in Scheufele. Ask for it at your local bookstore. Thank you for joining me today, and see you in the next video.